to clean water upon you, and you shall be cleansed from all your filthiness and from all your idols. Physical water can wash out all God and Jesus Christ. Out of your soul and out of your heart. Read that. Go back now to that. No, I just quote here. Go back now. To Matthew
11.
Yes.
I indeed baptized you with water unto repentance.
So John was saying, I indeed baptized you with water, physical water, unto repentance. Meaning that you should turn away. But he mentioned something else, which in Christendom they have overlooked it. But he, the conjunction, but he.
That cometh after me.
That cometh. Why is he baptizing and mentioning something else? But he.
That cometh after me.
That cometh after me.
Is mightier than I.
What? Is mightier than I. So which one is baptized at the
one? Mightier one.
Not the mightier one?
Yes.
He says, he that cometh after me, or I. Is mightier than I, read.
Whose shoes I am not worthy to bear.
Whose shoe I am not even worthy to carry.
He shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire.
John shall baptize you. Did he say John?
No.
Who is he will baptize you?
John.
He said he. But John was, he said, suffered to be so now, John. But does it become a us to fulfill all righteousness? So he was fulfilling baptism. He brought baptism to an end. Go and look up the meaning of fulfill. It means finish, complete, bring to an end as a promise. John said, I indeed baptize you with water. But John didn't say he was baptizing the man with the Holy Spirit. But he said that he
shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit.
Say so your pastor the Holy Spirit?
No.
He said, he shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit. Can your pastor baptize you with the Holy Spirit?
No.
Can your man baptize you with the Holy Spirit?
No.
Did he say the man will baptize you and you get the Holy Spirit?
No.
Never said that, you know. They said the pastor baptized them and they got the Holy Spirit. But that is a wrong bank and that was good. Listen what it says. Read back that little part.
I am baptized with water unto repentance.
Yes, repentance means to turn away.
But he that cometh after me.
So he that cometh after me.
Is mightier than I.
Who is mightier than I.
Whose shoes I am not worthy to bear.
Whose shoes I am not worthy to bear.
He shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire.
You ever seen a pastor baptize somebody with the Holy Spirit and fire?
No.
Acts the second chapter. This is the baptism. And you tell me who did this. You see, from this day, the kingdom of heaven has been opened up. From the day of Pentecost. He shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. If he didn't say with the Holy Spirit alone, the pastors come in and they say they baptize you, but they don't have the Holy Spirit part. So once you leave off anything, something is wrong. Because he said, he shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire.
Acts chapter 2.
Yes, and then the woman at Jacob's well, then Ephesians that says one baptism. So you can't tell me that the pastor baptized you in water and then the Holy Spirit baptized you again. Because he says two baptisms in the Bible, he said one. There's one faith, that's Ephesians 4 and 4. One baptism. So if you ask your pastor to baptize you, and then you say you want to be baptized by the Holy Spirit. So wait. What are you saying? The Holy Spirit can't manage. Then he should get some help from the pastor. Look at it's a simple thing. If you say, Dana will do something, and then when I look and see somebody say, they will do it. It's like somebody's confused. Because John clearly says, I am in baptized with water and repentance, meaning to turn away from. But he shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Not many days end. And if not many days end was Pentecost. Read.
Acts chapter 2, verse 1.
Yes.
And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place.
They were all with one accord in one place.
And suddenly, there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind.
There came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind.
And it filled all the house where they were sitting.
Yes.
And there appeared unto them cloven tongues, like as of fire, and sat upon each of them.
We never see pastor baptize anybody, they see any fire on them. You see that it's the Holy Spirit doing the baptizing?
That's right.
It's only the Holy Spirit can baptize any soul.
Right.
Because the baptism wasn't of the physical man. It was of the inner man. And that's what John meant.
And 3 verse 4. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit.
So you are all filled with the Holy Spirit.
And began to speak with other tongues.
Death, burial, resurrection, ascension, blood, water, spirit, part in the name of Yahshua.
As the Spirit
gave them utterance. So that is the true baptism. That is the spiritual baptism. Because John was the one who made mention of it. And said that he shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit. And that baptism is still going on up to today. And with fire. That's the Holy Spirit baptism. Read, please. That is
John 3, verse 6.
Yes.
Now, Jacob's well was there. Yahshua, therefore, being weary.
And Ephesians 4 and 4. Read.
With his journey, sat thus on the well.
Yes.
And it was about the sixth hour.
Read.
There cometh a woman of Samaria.
So there cometh a woman of Samaria.
To draw water.
To draw water.
Yahshua said unto her, give me to drink.
And Yahshua said unto her, give me to drink.
For his disciples were gone away unto the city to buy meat.
Read.
Then said the woman of Samaria unto him.
Read.
How is it that thou being an Israelite askest drink of me, which I am a woman of Samaria?
Yes.
For the Israelites and the have no dealing with the Samaritans.
Read.
Yahshua answered and said unto her.
Yes.
If thou knewest the gift of Yahweh.
Did he say the words?
The gift of
the pastor is speaking about the gift. The pastors are talking about the work of the Lord. Is it the same?
No.
He said, if thou knowest the gift of Yahweh. Because he is the gift of Yahweh. That's Yahshua the Messiah.
Right.
But Yahweh so loved the world that he gave Yahshua as a gift. As the gift of life. Read.
And who it is that said to thee, give me to drink.
Read.
Thou wouldst have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water.
What?
Living water.
Living water? Is that the water in the
No.
Is that the water in the pool at the church?
No.
I didn't know anything about living water until I came down here. Living water? Just like Joshua said, I am that bread that came down from heaven, that a man may eat the earth and shall never die. I am the bread of life. Joshua is the bread of life. I didn't know anything about that living water until I came to class. And this is the water that wash away sin. It makes sense. Can you see him physically?
No.
Could you take the right from the river and wash away sin?
No.
Where is the sin? The Bible says the soul that sin it shall die. Is it the body that has the sin or the soul?
The soul.
So how can the pastor reach his soul to wash it? This is only Yeshua can wash away sin. That's why John said the only Lamb of Yahweh. That taking away the sin. He didn't say we all right up over the river. That is stupid. You're not stupid. He did not say we all get me John 1:29 to support what we are saying. He did not say we all right up over the river that take it away the sin. He did not say we all the big pool at the church that take it away the sin. So who take away the sin? Read.
Let's read down to
just that verse that what time?
The next day John said, Yahshua coming unto him.
Yes.
And said, behold.
And said, behold.
The Lamb of Yah, which taketh away the sin of the world.
Which taketh away, that's enough. Behold the Lamb of Yah, who is Yahshua the Messiah, who taketh away the sin of the world. That's why Yahshua is the living water.
That's right.
So sin is not physical. Can you go to the shop and buy a pound of sin?
No.
Class, can you go to the shop and buy a pound of sin?
No.
So can it take physical water to wash away something that is spiritual?
No.
Let me tell you something. If I'm drinking a cup of tea, my soul is drinking tea too.
No.
So how is it soul sustained by what I'm by? Is your soul alive?
Yes.
Something that is alive must be kept alive by something or someone.
Yes. Yeah,
that's why Yahshua says the ear tried words as the mouth tasted me. So all your soul eat.
Sorry.
By knowledge. Knowledge, wisdom, knowledge, intelligence, love, beauty, justice, foundation, power, and strength. The root word of knowledge is no. That's why Yahshua says, know the truth, and the truth shall not just soul. So no water can wash away your sin. And the sin is in the soul. The sin is lies and hypocrisy. This Lord God and Jesus Christ is a continuation of that same lie that was told back here. That's why it takes the Holy Spirit to eradicate those lies. By his death, burial, and resurrection. So it's not, the devil, you are no match to the devil. Come on to die there and resurrect and glory, gloriously. to confront that serpent. Don't believe that you are in a match with that devil. And what the Christendom going on can say just so, I'll take away this thing. Brother, physical water can't take away sin. It takes something bigger than that, or someone greater than that. Let's see that sin. Look at the crime rate and look how many churches in Germany. This man in the shoot up here, they shoot up there, and now it's other crazy things going on. All you people praying, it's getting worse. But in Yeshua, Yeshuans are not afraid to walk or go anywhere. Because Yeshuans don't run from the devil. Because Yeshua says all power is given to Yeshua in heaven and earth. So they should be running from us. We are not afraid to live anywhere or go anywhere. And Yeshua cover us by his resurrection. Hallelujah. In his blood, in his name. Hallelujah. Yahweh Elohim ruleth in the kingdom of man. So if you want to come to class and say you're afraid of demons, are you afraid? You will sleep there, so afraid to leave you. Don't be afraid. Because Yahweh says, fret not thyself because of evil words. So we are not afraid to go anywhere. Once you have faith in Yahshua, he will protect us. And he has been protecting us from the devil. Because we don't run from the devil. The devil should be running from us.
That's right.
All right. Read what you have here now.
John bear record.
Yes.
Say, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
and it's a hold upon him.
Yes.
Hallelujah. But he that sent me to baptize with water, he said unto me, upon whom thou shalt see the Spirit descending and remaining on him.
Yes.
That same is he which baptizeth with the Holy Spirit.
So the same man that John is about to baptize, the Holy Spirit revealed to John. That is the man going baptized with the Holy Spirit. John, so you want the Holy Spirit baptism? Anybody who listens to the pastor and rub people in it, and you know you have to pay for the baptism in the church?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is you think it's free? Yeah. Pastor said the more people baptize, the more money he gets.
Yeah.
But John, read about that. John says, the Holy Spirit told John, John, you were baptized that man physically, no? But that man was baptized with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Is it the same? I'm not the same.
No.
When I baptized in water, when I baptized with the Holy Spirit.
John,
and that's why when you were speaking to that woman at Yaakov's bed, I want that scripture completed before John 4. Read me, check on that.
John 1:33.
Yes.
I knew him not.
So John said, I knew him not.
But he that sent me to baptize with water.
He said, he. So the same man, he said, he that sent me to baptize with water.
The same said unto me.
The same said unto me.
Upon whom thou shalt see the Spirit descending and remaining on him.
Yes.
The same is he which baptizeth with the Holy Spirit.
You want something clearer than that?
John 1.
John was baptizing people in water. And John said the Spirit told him that the man that you see the Spirit, go home and read it, descended on and remaining on him. He is the man who was going to baptize you with the Holy Spirit.
And
with fire. And John prophesied. That's why he was able to prophesy when he was baptizing Yahshua. He said, and he spoke back there and he says, that he shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire, not many days hence. And that Holy Spirit baptism is still going on.
Yeah.
All right, complete the woman of Jacob's way.
Chapter 4, verse 11.
Yes, Acts 19 and 1. And then we're going to wrap up. Read.
The woman said unto him.
The woman said, because she heard about this living water now. So it's the first she hearing about it. Living water. Read.
Sir. Thou hast nothing to draw with.
So she thought it was the physical water. So she started to say something to you. Explain to you.
And well is deep.
And well is deep.
From whence then hast thou that living water?
Where are you going to get that living water?
Art thou greater than our father, Jacob?
Yes. Listen to what he said.
Which gave us the well and
which gave us
the himself.
Read.
And his children and his cattle.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yahshua answered and said unto her.
Yahshua answered and said unto her.
Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again.
He said, whosoever drinketh of this physical water shall thirst again. That's why in John 7 he said, if any man thirst, let him come unto me, Yeshua, and drink, and out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. And thus he spake of the Holy Spirit. Welcome to the kingdom of righteousness, peace, and joy.
Hallelujah.
And we need you to come in. Come on board. Because the days are numbered,
yeah.
And it's the last lap.
Yeah.
So we are telling you, Yahshua is really breathing on you now.
That's right.
To receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Because Yahweh so loved the world that we're giving away free food. Because man didn't need angel food. That's in the book. Yahshua the Messiah is the only king and potentate of Yahweh.
Only.
We are crowned of glory and garments of life. The centurion said, "Just speak the word only, and souls will be healed." So when you call upon Yahshua, he says, "Call upon me, and I will show you great things." People talking about magic. This is a great miracle. So just like when you preach the gospel, the souls are cleansed, and the name, things happening. Don't believe that you will never be the same when you hear about this living water. Man is a tree, you know, physically and spiritually, you are a tree because you have roots. But your soul is a spiritual tree, so it needs living water to water it.
Yes.
And these are the words of eternal life.
Yes.
Yahshua resurrected from our soul. We can't get this from the universe. This is from the universe. The lady said, "From whence you want to get this living water?"
Yeah.
You ever hear the pastor talk about this yet?
No.
From whence? And what did he say?
Verse 14.
Mm-hmm.
"But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him."
The water that I, not the pastor, that I shall give him.
Shall never thirst. "But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water, springing up into everlasting life."
But when the pastor baptizes you, where the water is, the outside.
Yes.
And you don't even want taking that dirty water. Because sister, you're a water wash
machine.
And the pig pen, if it's a river, the pig pen upstream. You're not going down to Rayacob River to drink it. And I see people baptized it. And they're a pig pen upstream. So if you're going to bed to wash away dirt, would you pick up some dirty water and bed?
No.
Which water upon the face of the earth is clean?
No.
Yahshua is the only clean water.
Right.
That washes soul.
Right.
If you boil the water and it starts to cool, the germs from the atmosphere going in the same. And she was concerned. She said, "Well, whence then you're going to get this living water?" Yahshua said, "On me." And that great day of the feast, Yahshua stood and cried, "If any man thirst," he said, "blessed are they that come and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled." So your soul needs knowledge. And if you learn something and the knowledge transforms soul. Why do you think the doctor transforms into a doctor? By physical knowledge.
Yeah.
That's when he becomes a doctor. A teacher, a nurse. They get the knowledge. And Yahshua prayed in the garden of Gethsemane in the night. And he said, "These words make Yahshua and lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour is come, glorify thy son, that thy son may also glorify thee. As thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should give and say eternal life to as many as thou hast given. And this is life eternal, that they might know him, the only true Elohim, and Yahshua the Messiah, the Lord." Which part of the church ever going to give them a submission? All the pastor, the pan. Can I find rock, God? You know, this is what that they think the Almighty can defend himself. Who can? You want the Almighty when somebody can rock? May I look somebody to protect me? May I look somebody to protect me? And the man said, "You know, so then just rap God." So he said, "The what's going to happen to me? If a man just rap God, I don't find that. Then that God spent me jumping and down. Then if you have a bodyguard and you hear some man just beat him up, first thing you start drumming a candle and say, God, that's all this. I don't find that. So you don't want to hear that story about who want to rob God. Then he created all the diamonds. Whose island is that over there in the way?
Yeah.
I was in common geography, but Yahweh is not there. But we're just using an example to show how corrupt they are. All the islands in Arabia and the diamonds are this precious stones. They belong to the creator. So what do they have to offer? So I'm telling you, Yahweh gave us Yahshua as the gift of life. And that's why Yahshua said to them back there, "Go teach my people." And back there they had school, they didn't have any church. Yahshua used to walk and teach people knowledge. So you may grow in grace. Why go to church and sing the same song that you knew before? How are you learning? Suppose you have a child and you send that child to school every day, she come back and sing a song that she could stay home and sing. Why send her to school? They have nothing to offer because what they are saying, you could just go and read up on it. But this about the creation, about Yahweh, the wise in the creation, the bread saying Yahweh, the donkey praise Yahweh, and the witnesses and all the vision and the revelation of Yahweh. They don't have it. And I'm telling you this. We're inviting you to come at the end. You're not going to get it in one shot. And learn. That's what he said. Learn at me. That's why he says, come unto me, all that have labored and every day. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. Because I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your soul. Wrap me up now, that quick.
Acts chapter 19, verse 1.
Yes.
And it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth,
yes,
Paul only passed through the upper coasts.
Right. And he met some people who were baptized with John's baptism. Read.
Came to Ephesus.
Came to Ephesus.
And finding certain disciples.
Read.
He said unto them, have ye received the Holy Spirit since ye believed?
Read.
And they said unto him,
yes,
we have not so much as heard.
Then they were baptized by John. And then immediately in their mouth the Holy Spirit. But what you go receive Holy Spirit. And they themselves declared that. We didn't even hear about the Holy Spirit. Listen to the question that was asked.
Acts 19, verse 3.
Yes.
And he said unto them, unto what then were ye baptized?
So if you don't receive any Holy Spirit, unto what then are you baptized?
And they said, unto John's baptism.
So John's baptism is not the Holy Spirit baptism. And if so far down the line they are admitting that. Hey. And people come and pick up the same thing and say, the water can give the Holy Spirit.
Nonsense.
Listen, Holy Spirit give the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Suppose you want the doctor. When you go to see a lad,
no.
You want the Holy Spirit, you go to the Holy Spirit.
Right.
So yes, you want the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
So they think the Holy Spirit need a mediator. He is a mediator. Do you ever go to the doctor and the doctor talk to you, look after the doctor, where's the doctor? That's it. He's a psychotic. If there's a phone call for you, don't I give you the phone directly? I just answer the phone and say, deal with the person. I'm not going to say, I'm going to speak on your behalf. The Holy Spirit doesn't need a mediator.
Yes.
And you think he's not intelligent? Which man upon the face of the earth you think greater and more intelligent than the Holy Spirit?
No.
So all the anger was something to the past, and we are telling them that the Holy Spirit is here. He's not antiquated. He's not out here in the sun, moon, and stuff. He said, I never leave thee nor thy believers. Lord, with you always, even unto the end. And he says, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. Power to save soul. Power to resuscitate dead soul. Wrap me up.
Acts 19, verse 4, continue. Then said Paul,
yes,
Gehenna, verily baptized with the baptism of repentance.
So he's repeating it. Read.
Saying unto the people that they should believe on him, which should come after him. That
so
is
John
on,
was talking about Yeshua.
On Yeshua the Messiah.
That is on Yeshua the Messiah.
When they heard this,
when they were
baptized in the name.
They were baptized in
of
the name.
Of the Savior, Yeshua the Messiah.
So faith coming by hearing. Okay. Colossians 1. So the true baptism took place under the effect of us, and it's on the inside.
Yeah.
That's why Yahshua cried and said, if any man trusts, let him come unto me and give. So Yahshua is that river of living water. So you don't want your soul to be washed down here by Ryan Kobe. And now there's a little girl, you know. Because some people baptizing in Ryan Kobe and there's a pump house.
Yeah.
Did you know that there's a pump house in some city?
Yes, sir.
And I was just saying, they're all not baptized. And the pump house and it paid upstream. You can't use dirt. You wash away dirt. Yeshua is a living water. And this is where you get rest. He said, this is the rest where we may cause it to rest. And this is the refreshment. Alright.
Even the mystery.
So even the mystery.
Which have been hidden from him.
So all this knowledge was hidden to us. So Yeshua is revealing it in our heart.
But now it's made manifest
to his sons.
To whom Yahweh would make known.
Yes.
What is the riches of the glory of his ministry?
What is it? Yes.
Who is Yahshua the Messiah in you?
So Yahshua the Messiah in our heart. So that's the gift.
The only hope of glory.
The only hope of glorification.
We preach.
So we are preaching that Yahshua is resurrected in our heart.
Warning
them. And at the same time, we are warning you if you believe that Lord God and Jesus Christ, Allah Buddha, is your Savior, you shall die in your sin. There's one Savior and that's Yahshua the Messiah.
That's right.
And teaching every man.
And that's why it says, teach. You talk about talking about can a man rob God, we are teaching people. teach the people. That's what Yahshua said.
In all wisdom.
In all wisdom. So you're wise when you come to these classes.
That we represent every man.
Perfect. So the soul go in the knowledge of Yahshua. All praise is going to Yahweh, Elam, and his son, Yahshua Messiah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Now we're coming to the end of this afternoon lecture on behalf of the Institute of Divine Metaphysics Research and Cooperative Council for me. Now, is there any question pertaining to what we're saying? Any question, maybe, what's the question now? Good evening again,
Good evening.
We have been announcing our annual seminar. It will be happening on the 11th and the 12th of February. Now this seminar will be up by Champion College. We are starting 10 o'clock to 6 o'clock in the evening, each day. No class will be earlier on that day. That Sunday, everybody will be. And this is coming. The three school, you have three schools in Jamaica, you have the one in Maldoli, you have Spanish Town, you have Kingston. Three schools will combine and come with us seminar. There will be different speakers, you have speakers coming from the state. It's really one teacher, but you know, Yahshua, but you have different vessels coming, you understand? Also, food and refreshment will be on sale, right?
We have drink and sale
now, after class. Also, you know, we have We will start in that day. I think the Saturday will be the testimony from our sister, Dr. Sharon. Say, go on, hear the testimony of what happened. Because y'all need some great miracles in this school. And we need our sister Sharon. Say, go on, hear the full story come. And this time, take a friend. Also invite anybody who wants to invite. All is open all to the public. You understand me? Take a friend, take him your enemy. Because good for your enemy, you're the teacher. You understand me? Right? So after, remember 11th of February and the 12th of February 2017. It will be a wonderful seminar. You understand? Always a wonderful seminar. Also, Dr. Frank Lewis will come here. Y'all willing on time, lads. He'll be here next Sunday. You understand? He'll come in on Saturday if y'all are willing. So, we expect everybody to be here. No, also expect everybody present to be at the seminar. Right? It's free. You don't have to pay. All you have to do is pay your divine attention. Come with the hardest question that you want to ask. And we will have someone to answer. All the things about them over the years. Come and you can ask a question and we have somebody to answer this question. You get into things. The theme of the seminar will be a lot of time. The scripture we're using for that seminar with the First Timothy 4. Right? So the team is all about the latter time, right? So come on here, Jesus. Okay, thank you.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, just have something to say. So, right? All them people I was saying. Jesus Christ, Lord God, I sincerely feel it all means to them, praise Yahweh, God God. I see them have no partaking of Yahshua's future.
Well, Acts 17,
Acts 17, verse, Acts chapter 17, verse 28. Said, for in him we live, move, and have our being. He has certain also of our own prophets has said, for we are also his offspring. Verse 30 says, and the times of this ignorance Yahweh winked at, but now commandeth all men everywhere to repent, because he has appointed a day in which he will judge the world in righteousness by that man whom he hath ordained, whereof he hath given assurance unto all men, in that he hath raised him from the dead.
Just like Yahshua is the judge.
So,
and after his death, burial, and his resurrection, notice when he was on the cross, he did this. Notice, he was reaching to those before him and after him. And then the two hands came down in the body. So he's the one who walked out the age that is dispensation at the time. Now it says, after his death, burial, and his resurrection, I use this title chart because this is kind of low.
That's a big one.
Yeah. It's alright. I'll use this here. So after his death and his burial and his resurrection, he went back and preached to those spirits in prison who died before him, because the same question you're asking. We could think about those persons before he was born. What about those souls? So those that were born before him and died believing in the Redeemer, he went back and preached to them. And that's why behold, now is the day of salvation. And he is the one who is ordering the affair and doing everything, because he is the master of souls. He says, all souls are mine. And it's not that, since the souls came in the flesh, he's from eternity to eternity, so he knows the soul. Just like every strand upon your head, Yahweh knows them. And he knows all the creatures, so it's not a problem for him to save anybody or to damn anybody. He knows all the souls. So time abides in eternity. And all souls are eternal. All souls are from eternity to eternity. Because remember that the soul is the spirit part of the man. The body can die, but the soul will live on throughout eternity. So he knows the soul. So it doesn't matter the dispensation or when the soul was in or out of a physical body. He knows the soul. So just like you know all your children, and if you have 10 children and there's one child, you know that child, isn't that so? Suppose you have all of us in here were your children, and you have one stranger is in here, you would know that that child is not yours. So that's why he says, my sheep hear my voice, and a stranger, they will not follow. Just like the prophet's heard, he appeared in vision before his birth to Isaiah, Zechariah, Nehemiah, Zephaniah, and he's still appearing in vision and revelation up to today. So right through the age and dispensation of time, he appeared. And that's why he appeared here to Adam in the garden. Here, and he gave him a law. Right, he's the same man walking on the age and dispensation. He was the same man who gave Adam the law. So he's the same man operating up to today. So
Need for water baptism.
No, he's the Holy Spirit. He's the Holy Spirit.
Spirit. Yahshua.
Baptizing.
Yes.
Not any physical.
So was Yahshua.
Huh?
It's in the Bible that like he went in the water.
Yeah, to fulfill baptism.
Yeah.
That's like, if you go back and read it, he said, suffer to be so now, Jampa, does it become us to fulfill? Us to fulfill.
So it was just water.
He was fulfilling, he was established. He brought fulfilling means to bring to an end. So when he baptized, he brought physical baptism to an end. It was set up 1500 years before he came at the Red Sea. And he says in 1 Corinthians said that they were all baptized unto Moses in the cloud and in the sea. To confirm that it was a baptism, it began at the Red Sea. So Yahshua brought that physical baptism to an end. To set up the true baptism, which is the of the heart and the appendical, which is spiritual. Because you need the baptism is a washing, you know.
Yeah.
So you need the washing of the soul, not the body. Because the sin is in the soul. Because it says the soul, let's say the child died. It's not the body's sin, it's the soul.
So you're going to a church and preach something. Teach something.
Church?
Yeah, I'm going to a church and teach something.
We don't really go to the churches.
Soul needs to be one, you know.
Yeah, we preach all over the island. We have been on the Ian program, we have been on the streets, we have been all over.
And we're on YouTube.
And
we're
on YouTube.
You haven't got to a pastor yet at a church that God knows. I said, listen, we have someone warm to teach people today. Warm to teach.
I'm not going to do that.
God, you should never run for going away.
I'm not going to do that.
All right. You have been at the plaza.
Yes,
I made appointments with pastors too. We are really there.
God, I need forget this.
I know they need to get the teaching, but we have been preaching. You're saying they need, but yes, you're correct. We have been preaching.
Because man said one Lord, one name, one baptism. So I do not see where it's saying the man I really changed the name to nobody. So there's no need, it's about Jesus Christ now. From where you will be said that, and we are saying rain, so we run. You understand?
Yes, that's true.
Come about with a name, name why?
Yes.
Mr. Dalamud, if me are Chinese, if me are Indian, if me are German, why are why? So people need to look at me.
I've been preaching.
How many people can I read now? And in the past, I read for them and I tell them what to say.
Working by appointments.
Yeah.
So if you notice the scripture that was read, he said he has appointed a day.
Yeah.
So their day will come.
Yeah.
And we have been preaching right around the island.
Today is your day.
Yeah. So I have you anything else?
Before we go, I just have to ask some first timer. I would ask the first timer to just please stand and see anybody can acknowledge it, please.
You have a German name named Gerard.
Gerard.
Yeah, Gerard Bola.
Bola.
Yeah, friend called me Teddy.
Gerard Bola.
Bola. B-O-R-E-L-A-N-D.
Gerard. Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming. Miss Charlene Williams. Let me say on behalf of the Institute of Divine Liberty Research Incorporated, thanks for coming. Thanks for coming. And certainly, I hope you'll take time out to come down here again and study with us. Alright? Okay, now we are at the end. This class is scheduled here at the Spanish Town High School. Corner of Ellis and Young Street, Tuesdays and Thursdays from the hour of 7:30 till 9:30. However, sometime we stop at Sundays from 4 till 6 p.m. And over in Kingstown at 94 B, all the work for Wednesdays from 6 till 8 p.m. Fridays from 6 till 8:30 p.m. and Sundays from 11 a.m. till 1 p.m. Please stop for us. Exceeding joy to the only wise Elohim, Yahshua the Messiah, belong glory, majesty, dominion, and power above now and forever, we say.
Hallelujah.